Well, happy Tuesday, everybody. The day after Memorial Day. I didn't get to make a video this weekend, so I'd like to still say God bless all our vets. Love each and every one of you. But here we are this morning, out in the big sea of dirt. We finally got some rain last night. I mean, it didn't even hardly rain at the house. But I guess a line somewhere from here to old past Devin Wayne 69's house, it just tore it up. Just tore it up. Man, I'm glad to see the corn where it's at. It's averagely about 10 inches, most of it. Some less, some a little more. But still, lots to see. Be a while before it gets waist high, but man, it's been starving for rain. Well, you guys know, for weeks. So just this little bit of rain, man, this stuff in days will jump. And overnight, I've watched corn jump 6 inches or better. It's crazy. But, man, what a way to get the day started. 11 o'clock, sweating like a... We won't say. But I just stepped into this field. Last time is somewhere right in there where I picked up that little Dixon. Oh, right there. Look what we got. A little Dixon. Oh, and I'm running the new camera today. I already took that little... Oh, look at that. Oh, how awesome. Hopefully this camera does a good focus when you come up to, look at that pink on that. And shame that shoulder was knocked off, but I love it anyways. Well, may not have as good as a day as OFS did here a while back. That was awesome, buddy. But like Billy said and a few others, that's a hunt of the year, probably. Yeah, stellar. Run a new Fuji FX55 rugged camera, 16-foot waterproof, so much crush-proof, shock-proof, dust-proof, crazy-proof, whatever. Woohoo! Yep. Awesome. Well, let's get after them. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Check this out real quick. I mean, I run into a few turtles out here. Usually baby turtles, because there's a slough farther down. A little bitty spring over there. But this is the biggest one I've ever run into out here. It's out here laying eggs or something. Which I don't know. I know a lot of them have already been laying eggs. But it's too hard. It looks like he's got pretty muddy. If he has a tough time moving around, I may move him to the grass when I come back out. We'll see how he does. Phew, it's hot out here. Oh man, I mean hot. Hot, hot, hot. But, I just jigged something out. Eh, well, I gotta catch some with me that just don't, that happens like that, because that's why I carry this stick here, see? So I can poke at stuff so I really know it's something. And not just a flake or whatever. But, nice edge. A little bit of tip knocked off, but the butt end's all there. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Oh, back to finding some more. And there. Boy, I just love this field. Looks like it's got a little tip damage. Yeah, big old impact break on it. Look at that. So, that Indian chucked this baby. Throwed it at something. Ate dinner off of it. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Translucent. Yeah, kinda. Just the edges. Not much. Thank you, my great ancestors. I appreciate everything you let me find. Thank you very much. Thank you. Whew, sweat just rolling. I don't like the heat no more. And I grew up as a roofer. But boy, well, since being out of it for 6 years, almost seven. And then now I got to take this thyroid medication, so I don't know if it's going to affect me in the heat or not. But it's supposed to rain again Thursday. And we're supposed to cool off, so that'll be nice. But yeah, I can already see I'm going to have a lot of downtime this summer. This heat just kills me, boys. Well, back to pounding more sea. And the flint it is for me. Flint for me. Well, I did a little short vid the other day out in the yard with this camera. Posted it on FB, just showing some flowers and stuff. But, just to see if kind of quality was or whatever. And I need to get more used to moving slow. I think that makes a big difference. Then you don't have to use that shaky option, which I haven't been using. But, I just found this tip in here. Wow, look at the fire pop out of it on that side. Huh, but I had found some other, few other broke things. This base here. Kind of ground in the ears. It might be a Johnson. Had that tip, and then that broken Etley, and then the broken tool right there, and then the rest is, well, that little edge you see, I need some flake I've been saving. Look how that flake there's been pedestaled. That's a good inch of rain. Who knows how much dirt was on it before that. But I'm gonna shove this stuff in a pocket and keep on going. Need to get down there some. I ain't covered all that hill. Well, try to spend a couple days out here anyways. Glad it has some rain. Making my way through this. Now it's just one great big field. Just one big field. Used to be that tree line that ran right through there. It's always had this little ditch before it. And it's hard to tell. I know they dragged dirt around, but we're thinking they may have brought some dirt in. I don't know. It's hard to tell. I'm hoping they didn't. Because for years, every time the river would get up and wash all that soft sand and everything down this way and dirt, it would drop a lot of bird points, the little flakes, even points and stuff right there at that hump and all them trees and stuff. So I'm hoping through the years it really starts spitting out a lot. Who knows? Best times to find a lot of bird points out here is when the river eats it. Which, this is silage corn. And they're a $1 billion cattle company. It wouldn't hurt them too much. They've got insurance for stuff like that. But I'd love to see that river eat this field right now. I'm just glad it's got some rain on it and getting a chance to hunt. But either I got a faker or a little chopper or something. May have been a chunk of a chopper. Just a big knocked over pretty nasty piece. How's that for focusing on material? Is that showing it pretty good? I can kind of see the background looks more clear to me. I don't guess there's a way. I don't know. For cleanup, I'm going to try it at home on the tripod. I'm going to go get me a shade break pretty soon. Hot. Up here in this other field, had me a little break in the shade, but man, it wasn't long enough. Oh, but I spied that laying there. Looks like a, well, yep. It's all there. It's a Dixon. Kind of roughish. Made out of some all pink material. Little purple spot in the middle. Boy, but that'll look sweet cleaned up. You betcha. Got, pretty thin. Cool little tip on it. Cool. Very, very nice. I don't sweat very easy, but man, I tell you what, it's hot today. And hopefully, I've been waiting to find a nice pull for a break. Here's a tip sticking out. Whether it's all there or not, I think I'm going to still go take a break. Ooh, come on, come on. Nope, just a big tip. And, oops, sorry. Don't you know that'd have been off something killer? Oh well. A little breeze once in a while, but some of it's even warm. Man, I think Thursday was supposed to rain again and cool off. That'll be nice. I don't know what I got here. If I got a piece of material or a nice faker. Nice faker. Looked like part of a Dixon sticking out. Well, uncut and unedited, there it is. Boy, did I mention it was hot out here today? Man, I can't wait to come out here and get something ice cold to drink at the store. Big old fountain Dr. Pepper.
Got some kind of a base sticking out here. Ooh, is it all there? Oh,
will you look at that? Oh, will you look at that? Wasn't that a killer pull? Shoot, yes, man. Awesome. Friggin' blade, man. Right at 3 1/8, man. Oh. I just love blades. Look at that. That'll make a real nice addition to my blade case. Shoot, yes. Awesome. That was a killer pull, man. And I thought it was going to be a broke. Awesome. You know, that one's going to have to get wrapped up in some paper. Killer. Any translucency to it? Nope. Well, we'll be seeing it on the cleanup, won't we? Yeehaw. Stealth.
Well, I'd only seen just a little bit sticking out. I'll touch it with the other hand. I keep trying to keep one hand clean for the camera, which it is dust proof, but the less dirt on it, the easier it is to keep it clean. Some kind of chopper tool. Scraper. Choppers. That's what I call a lot of them. Tools like this anyways. I imagine you always find a lot of these kind. They're just chopped up. Ain't nothing particular.
And we know they ate from digging in shelters. We know they ate a lot of the bone marrow, and I'm sure it took a lot of rocks to chop them up and eat them. But boy, and I was hoping to walk a lot of this field out today, but I got like one little sip of water on me. I got set a piece of live action right there. Oh, what do we got here? It gets a piece with the tip knocked off. Some live action right there. Well, I'll be. Huh, I gotta get a picture. Okay, here we are back. What do we got? Live action or a faker? Oh, no, we got a That's a live action point, I tell you. Some of that oolitic material. There's so much of that stuff out here, man. It's like some of the stuff coming out of Salamander. And this Pulaski County Mosaicite is some beautiful stuff, man. I mean, Miller County, Camilton County, they all got good Mosaicite too. But, man, oh no. Something over here about it off this big creek. Well, at least a few clouds are going to start rolling in. Man. And I've learned through the years how to stretch my water. I've stretched it today. Guess I got one sip here and it's hot. But back over there by that big hill, I got another bottle of water. Yeah, this thing's only a 5x zoom. Watch you zooming out all the way. It does a lot of moving. More meant for tripod. Well, I'm liking it. It seems to be working good. Hopefully with the cleanup, it'll show real nice. Focus in when you put things up close. That's what's most important to me, is good clarity all the time. Well, I'm gonna keep pounding ground. Oh, wait till you see what I just spied. Ooh, one of them pulls that's gonna get our blood pumping. Got my blood pumping. I know it's gonna get your blood pumping. Lots of pressure. Broke. Broke. I put my lens tissue away. Oh well. I'm still thankful to find it. Still thankful to find it. I love these sandy fields. Not as good as old flint balls, but they're pretty good. They're pretty good. Looks like I might have something right here. Major. Flake. What a faker. Man, that was a good faker. Fake me in the dirt. Boy. That is a crying shame right there. Oh, yeah. Maybe fresh break. Oh, man. Some kind of woodland point. Man. Hot. I've said that a bunch today, ain't I? Oh, because it is. About... ready to turn around, walk my way out. I'm thirsty. So thirsty. Well, here we are with a little home cleanup from today. Was a pretty good day. So I think that's the first piece I found. Some kind of tool. Looks like. Had this little point here. Looks like that oolitic material. Uh-oh, battery just went red. That's not good. It's busted atly. That was a shame. Oh, check out this little tip here. Yeah, and this was a stellar find. Had this colorful tip here. I didn't film. Some banded stuff. Guys, let me know how this new camera's doing. Which, of course, I'll watch it myself. But, I mean, for what there was to pick from, it was the best. This is a cool Hopewell point.
a big old impact break. Got spear chucked. Then had that very first find right there. That's such a shame that little bit of shoulder got knocked off, but that's field finds for you. A stellar little Dixon. Just a stellar little Dixon. And then, let's move these aside here. Right, look at this little tip. Quartz pocket right there. Is it translucent? Kinda, sorta. Then there was this Dixon. It's made out of some pretty nice material. And then it's all there, tipping off. Well, kinda like distal tip, super thin. Just weird how it's shaped. I don't you think something like that material would whip out a much nicer point. And then the day maker. And I'm pretty sure and it's a Dina blade. I've got quite a few from out there. Everyone just seen, well, I still think that one I found that's 4 1/8 or 3/8, whatever it is an Adena blade. Terry thinks it's older, but no, it's don't have no grinding on it or nothing. Has really fine edge work all the way around both sides. This part of the base here don't, but boy, this side here does. A bunch of little bitty all the way around there. And it's been used a lot, but it's been sharpened too. Got that little sharpening twist to it. Well, there's a few things out in the field I wanted to talk about today, but man, it was so hot that I was lucky just to think about arrowheads. I had to keep all my concentration there for sure, but while I was out there, some mail come through on the phone, and it was Kurt Point posted a comment on my channel and says, "Hey man, what's up? Is someone trying to block you out or make this difficult on you? Somehow, someone marked your comments on my channel as spam. You, of all my friends on YouTube, would be the last person I would ever block out. Even though I have never met you personally, I think you are one cool dude, and I will be your back against this. Don't know who it is, but I'm betting they don't know just how many friends you got. If you see something on my channel says any different, then it's a lie. Always there for you any way possible, your friend Kurt Point." Thank you, Kurt Point, KP buddy. I always appreciate you. But a little note to the negative nature, you know, one of these days you guys are just gonna totally fade away, because we're gonna quit even paying attention to you guys. Because see, look at this phone here. We can just keep going on. Reply from Specs World, you know, that Volcanic Glass, Elvis, Kentucky Fox Trapper, TN Relic Hunter, BM51, Double Blade. It just keeps going on and on and on and on. Uploading conversation. We gotta load more. There's even more. And it just keeps going. And it just keeps going. Positivity is always gonna come over the negativity. You can't never win. Give it up. You know? A lot of times you'll see a dislike on a video and you're thinking, now why would someone want to do dislike that video? That is an awesome video. Great finds, great person. You know, who knows? They want to live in their miserable little world. We're going to let you. You can stay there. We are going to live on just like this. And it's going to keep going, and it's going to be on a roll forever, and you're never going to stop it. So swallow up in your own miserable little world. You don't do us
any harm. No harm. Well, and that means to most of us are dead.